secondly, your small team of staff feel that they have to be pursuing that debt to bring back into the council as much as they can of the money which is owed to the council. As we said, some of it is actually more than 6 years old, or some of it 4 or 5 years old. Unless we are actively pursuing that now and bring the money back in. Thirdly, you simply asked me to undertake a review and investigation of this matter to establish how we got into this situation and to learn lessons from it. To this end, we commissioned Eugene Sullivan, who until a few weeks ago was the chair of the National Audit Commission, to undertake this investigation to give some value to this review. And Eugene Sullivan started the work. He's interviewing these two key officers who are still here. He's going to the records in some depth. He's speaking to the district auditor in terms of their role in this process. And he expects to have a written report back to members sometime in mid-February. Therefore, we bring that report back to cabinet at that stage. Thank you, Jim.
Okay, so can we note that Neighbourhood Working should be there? Okay, that takes us to item 11, Neighbourhood Working, forging a modern relationship between council and residents. So this report is proposing a new model for Neighbourhood Working, and it's based on the concept of four constituency committees based on the constituency boundaries, and it's starting from the premise, I think, that there is a better way of managing at the neighbourhood level and forging a new partnership between local elected board members, residents, and voluntary community based sector and our public sector agencies. Jim was saying in this report that 6.2, the current model is actually very costly to the minister, £1,300 per annum per resident who attends per area forum, and the footprints of the current area forums are too small to coordinate services effectively. So the model that's being put forward is a four committees based on constituencies, with elected members, community reps, voluntary community based sector, and the local MPs if they are interested in getting involved. At least one MP has expressed an enthusiasm to me for doing that. And also embedded neighbourhood officers embedded in the constituency to provide support, advice, and assistance. I think personally this is quite an exciting model, and I know our colleagues in police, fire, and health have also expressed an enthusiasm to adopt the constituency model for their operations. I think this is also quite an exciting model in terms of our agenda that we talked add to this, this recommendation, so can we agree?
Agreed.
Item 13, committee calendar for the municipal year 2013-14.
Again, Chair, I'm going to provide the details of the calendarism for the following municipal year. We've had only your comments in relation to this matter, and question as to whether details of the calendar is of the interest committee and the licensing committee should be included within the calendar as well, as to whether or not that's a consideration for you. This is for you, but the calendar is set out the appendix for the
group. This is the kind of standard we bought. My only sort of question really about panels is where do we end? If we put the panels in, there are dozens of panels. So I'm just wondering practically, would that make sense? And also my question is, some of these panels are arranged for short photos. So I'm just asking for
Chair, it does make the economy a bit more busy in terms of detail and the different areas more difficult to schedule panels, just to make sure that the weights. It does depend on the workload of the various committees involved. So there are logistical issues that we have covered to look at, and it's probably simpler and easier for members to find countries with SCP panels.
Okay, well, what my suggestion is we agree this calendar. Which takes us then to item 14, vacant land and building review for the Rangers Cottage at Thurstaston. Do we need to? Is this you, Sir James?
Yes.
Thank you.
So, Genesis. The report is seeking approval for the disposal of the Rangers Cottage after all that. The park assessment has been done by the SMP team and confirmed that this pre-op property was required by the council. Approved this law for the last place disposal through water. There is an exempt appendix in relation to this particular item, which you'll need to consider.
Okay.
Adrian,
can we agree that recommendation? Agree, thank you. Item 15 is the local sustainable transport fund purchase. Transport tickets.
Okay, thank you, Chair. Members will be aware that back in October, the Council managed to secure a significant amount of external local sustainable transport funding. The fund consists of revenue and capital, so we've got capital investment into highway improvement schemes in the East Wirral area to help people get to employment sites. And the other element is that revenue, and a key part of that is what we call the travel solutions scheme. The idea behind the scheme, which I think members will recall, was to get a whole variety of interventions to help remove transport barriers for people and enable them to actually get into employment. So it's a whole variety of things around visual information, advice and guidance, journey planning, even the higher things like cycles and scooters and things like that to help people get to employment. One of the key aspects of the initiative that we're just looking to take forward now is some significant investments in travel cards. We know that from the experience that we've got, one of the real issues for people, particularly during their first month of employment before we get the first pay packet, is actually just physically being able to find the money to actually get to the job for that first month. So actually what we're proposing to do is to actually put a fairly significant amount of investment through Mersey Travel over the next 3 years. And the idea would be that we'd be spending round about up to £140,000 on tickets which Mersey Travel offer, primarily trio, solo and segway tickets. And these really are an ideal flexible ticket for people who can be used flexible product in these people to help people to get employment. Also, in the report, we talk about the fact that we think it would be very beneficial if we could buy investing at rail cars as well. And obviously, on the local network, Mersey Rail are the only provider. So really, for that reason, Chair, there's a whole variety of very good reasons why normally we go for competitive quotes by contract procedure. But on this occasion, we're suggesting that we get Cabinet approval for us to go directly to Mersey Travel as we really as a single sole provider of that. Certainly in terms of competition value for money, we do know that Mersey Travel work as a transport executive and actually operate in a completely competitive commercial environment. So, you know, so we're very confident in that regard. So we're just looking for Cabinet approval for that. That's a good question.
Okay.
Essentially, this is good news for the employee. You may be experiencing problems seeking access to employment, especially those in what you might describe poor public transport areas. Scheme gives unemployed people access, as Mark said, to the bikes, to buses, to ferries, to trains, and even, as Mark said, the 50cc scooter, vroom vroom. You know, in some circumstances, people will be able to travel. Essentially, people will be able to travel on major sites, within major sites. But on some occasions, they can travel as far as Chester, and to close here in special circumstances. So all in all, good scheme.
Okay, I think that's is a very positive scheme, and I think it's hopefully will help to get more people back into the labour market, which is great. So can we move on to the next? Okay, item 16 is Global Transport Capital Funding and the Integrated Transport Block Programme 2013-14.
Okay, thank you, Chair. As the report describes, back in January 2011, Cabinet advised of the government's local transport capital settlement and announced the amount of transport funding that would come to Merseyside authorities. 11, 12, 12, 13, and then there were indicative figures at that time, 13, 14, and 14, 15 as well. And at that time, the report also presented the background and the developments of the third local transport plan, which started in April 2011 and is now well up and running. The indicative figures for the settlement in 13, 14, and 14, 15 were confirmed by the Department of Transport last year, and this report presents the budget for the coming year 13-14 in accordance with that settlement letter. Just briefly by way of background, members will recall that via the recent Local Transport Act, Mersey Travel is the ITA, Integrated Transport Authority. Now, first of all, we now have full statutory responsibility for producing the local transport plan, obviously in partnership with the Merseyside local authorities. And in practical terms, the money actually comes into Mersey Travel as the ITA in the first instance. So actually on Merseyside, the ITA received in the region of about £13 million. I would highlight to Cabinet, as described in 2.6, that the ITA actually take money off at source, and it is important just to highlight that £950,000 of that overall settlement really form this core activity fund, and the kind of things that goes into is set out in 2.6 there. We talk about the road safety partnership and various other important things that really do need to be progressed at a Merseyside level. Really, the key purpose of this report is to really highlight that once that money is stiffed proposed road safety programme, which constitutes about 345,000, and the detail is there. Section 4 on page 147 sets out a programme for promoting active travel and health, which comes to 380,000 pounds. And the broad detail is in that heading of the top of the 4.1. Section 5 sets out a programme for reducing congestion and carbon emissions, which comes to 161,000. And you'll see there at the bottom of page 149, we've got a variety of things around traffic management measures, UTC, traffic patterns, and things like that. And then the final heading, at the top of page 151, we have that general heading, which we use for things like advanced design, forward planning, etc., which has £450,000 against that. So really, just moving to the recommendations, Chair, we're first of all looking for Cabinet in principle to approve the allocation between those four key blocks within our local transport plan programme, and then to actually approve the detailed programmes as set out in sections 3 to 6 under those headings. And then in the usual way, which members will be very familiar with, we're looking for Cabinet to delegate authority to the interior